Welcome to Train Sim World 2, an immersive and highly detailed rail simulation featuring authentic routes and trains from around the world. You've just been awarded some action points. These are displayed in the top right corner of the screen and count towards your overall experience. It is necessary to be fully observant of the surrounding world. Practice by looking up, This is one of many interactives to be discovered, but not all of them will be as easy to find as this one. A lot of time will be spent operating trains, so you can pause the experience at any point and review previous and current objectives. Check it out now and then return to the game when ready. A heads-up display has appeared on the right side of the screen. This is a guide to what the train is doing. This is the speed display. The white needle shows current speed. The red marker indicates the maximum permitted speed. This is the direction display. An arrow will indicate forward, reverse, and neutral directions. This is the power display. A number will indicate the position the power control is in. These are the brake indicators. They show the state of the various brake systems, allowing independent management of them. In the top right are the signal and speed limit displays. These feature an indication of what is approaching and a countdown distance to when they will come into effect. Some of these displays can be hidden via the settings menu for a more challenging experience. This train is ready to go. Push the indicated handle forwards to get moving. The Riesa to Dresden mainline runs for roughly 80 kilometers and runs both express and mainline passenger services, as well as a variety of freight from the local industries. Train Sim World 2 allows you to ride and drive from a selection of camera views. Let's take a look now while exploring this train. You've only explored a small area here, so let's take a look at what else there is to enjoy. Welcome to Dresden in eastern Germany, located in Saxony on the River Elbe. Experience a multitude of operations expanding out of the iconic Dresden Hauptbahnhof, with commuters and international travelers converging to make a hustle and bustle mix of S-Bahn, regional, intercity, and freight traffic. Along the way, be sure to place route maps, restock first aid points, paint garden gnomes, and clean up spray paint cans. Choose commuter or heavy freight traffic as you take a trip through the picturesque German countryside. Welcome to Riesa Dresden. Welcome to driver training. Today you'll be taken through the operation of this DBBR766.2. During this brief introduction, we'll go through the critical driving controls and passenger operations. When you're ready, climb aboard to get started. We will need to turn the power on. Set the battery switch to the on position. Take a seat in the driver's position. This is where you'll be spending most of your time. The reverser determines the direction of travel. Now activate the pantograph so that it raises up and makes contact with the overhead catenary. The train is ready to be energized. This is controlled by the main circuit breaker. This train is now ready to depart. Use the throttle to apply power and get moving. During the course of your journey, ensure that you are monitoring your speed and the amount of power that is applied. If too much power is applied from this control car, then this could cause the traction motors of the rear locomotive to cut out and prevent further power from being applied. This is not the case when operating a train with a BR146.2. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed. Keeping to speed limits is important. If you begin overspeeding, apply a small amount of brake by moving the train brake. You are now approaching the first stop. Apply a small amount of braking force using the train brake to achieve a comfortable and safe stop. Take a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe before unlocking the doors. Time to get going. Set the doors to locked. We will now cover traction locking and how to recover the train. A traction lock can come into effect in several different ways. If power is applied whilst the brakes are still applied, the traction lock will be engaged. Another instance of where this happens is if power is applied while the passenger doors are still unlocked. To simulate a traction lock, we'll first move the train brake into full service. Next, we'll need to apply some power to engage the traction lock system. The traction lock has now been triggered. This is represented on the HUD by a red outline on the power display. To recover from a traction lock, we need to ensure that power is not being applied. Set the throttle back to the off position. Finally, we need to make sure the train brake is set to the running position. Nice job. The traction lock has now been disengaged and we're now able to continue the journey. Proceed to the next stop, unguided this time, and see how you get on. Good work. That concludes all the basics of operating this train.
Sifa. 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 Sifa, Sifa. Sifa, Sifa. Sifa. Sifa, Sifa. Sifa. AFB, AFB, AFB. Sie fahren. Sie fahren. Sie fahren Zwangsbremsung.
Thank you. Bitte achten Sie auf den Abstand zwischen Zug und Bahnsteigkante.
Sifa.
Thank you.
Ziva. Ziva.
Welcome to Driver Training. Today you'll be taken through the operation of a BR146.2 electric locomotive in DB Traffic Red livery. During this brief introduction, we'll go through the critical driving controls and passenger operations. When you're ready, climb aboard to get started. In normal operation, this unit draws electricity from the overhead catenary via a pantograph. However, since the pantograph is currently in the down position, we have to power the initial systems by priming the auxiliary battery. The pantograph mode will need to be set before it can be raised. Set the pantograph selector to automatic. Set the exterior lights for normal. Take a seat in the driver's. With power available, use the reverser to. We will need to wait for the brake system to charge. Now activate the pantograph so that it raises up and makes contact with the overhead catenary. The reverser determines the direction of. Take a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe before unlocking the doors. Time to get going. Set the doors to locked. We will now cover traction locking and how to recover the train. A traction lock can come into effect in several different ways. If power is applied whilst the brakes are still applied, a traction lock will be engaged. Another instance of where this happens is if power is applied whilst the passenger doors are still unlocked. To simulate a traction lock, we will first need to move the train brake into full service. Next, we'll need to apply some power to engage the traction lock system. The traction lock has now been triggered. This is represented on the HUD by the red outline on the power display. To recover from a traction lock, we need to ensure that power is not being applied. Set the throttle to the off position. Finally, we need to make sure that the train brake is set to the running position. Nice job. The traction lock has now been disengaged and we're able to continue the journey. This train is ready to go. Use the throttle to apply some power and get moving. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce motor stress and maintenance requirements. Keeping the speed limits is important. If you begin overspeeding, apply a small amount of brake by using the train brake. You are now approaching the first stop. Use the train brake to apply a small amount of brake force to achieve a comfortable and safe stop. that concludes all the basics of operating this train.